It's amazing all over the world how celebrities get away with shit. I was reading an article about Oscar Pistorius, the Blade Runner. He got 6 years for killing an innocent woman, and now they're gonna give him 13, but that's still not enough. You all know who I'm talking about. Oscar Pistorius, the Blade Runner, killed his girlfriend. I can't stand that spatula foot motherfucker. I can't stand this. I can't stand this motherfucker right here. He wants his legs in jail because they won't let him have his legs. They could be used as a weapon or something. And he wants his legs. Plus, I don't want him comfortable. I don't care what you want. You killed an innocent girl. You should be uncomfortable. I want you in the shower every morning with big South African dicks in your face. That's how you're going to do your 13 years. You know? I want to see a motherfucker like this.
Come on, Mobutu, stop now, stop. You are uncircumcised, your dick stinks, stop.
I am trying to shower. He said he woke up in the middle of the night because he heard noise in the bathroom, but he didn't check to see where his woman was. He didn't even look. Come on, guys, you look, you wake up, and the first thing you do is you see where your woman is. And if your woman's not in bed and you're a real man, your first thought is, oh shit, where's my cell phone? That's your first thought. Yeah. I don't even go to the bathroom. I go to the top of the steps. Baby, you got my phone? You downstairs, you got my phone? Stop fucking around, give me my phone. My woman's always in my shit. I had to have some eye pajamas made. I had pajamas made with a pocket so I could get some sleep, you know? I had pajamas with a passcode made and shit. But she's the Copernicus of getting in a phone. She getting a motherfucker's phone. No matter what phone you got. I remember when I used to have passcode digits. I woke up one night and I heard, this is what I heard. I was like, what the fuck is that? I look on the side of the bed, she's got my phone doing this. That's some slick shit. Yeah, oh, y'all know that up here. You ladies, y'all ain't shit. Yeah, y'all know that. You breathe on the phone and fog it up and you can see the most frequently tapped password numbers. Yeah, he's like, uh-huh, that's his father's birthday right there. That's what that is. Oh, she's a trip. Hey, I woke up one night and she had my phone. She was over me and had my thumb too. And she was doing this on the new phone. I'm like, hey, give me my shit. You're not gonna bust me with my own fucking thumb. Nigga can't even get an Ambien nap in this motherfucker. I smell pee. Now I got the facial recognition. It's gonna take her at least a week. Because eventually she'll figure this shit out. Eventually she'll have hair around her mouth. Looking at my phone talking about, if loving you is wrong, I don't wanna be right. Hey, we getting ready to do a sequel, y'all. Coming to America 2. Yes. I'm excited. We old as hell, though, 30 years later. We so old, we won't have to use makeup for the barbers this time around. The sequel is based on a true story. Akeem and Simi come to America and beat the shit out of Jesse Smollett for that. Yeah. Everybody's mad. Nigeria, Wakanda, Zamunda, everybody's upset at what he did. It's not just Chicago. Simi, give me the bleach.